So, hi mom, this is my mom.
Hi.
Hi, her name's Bonnie, and she's also a teacher, and she is the influence, my number one influence for becoming a teacher. Isn't that nice? I wanted to clarify that I do have your permission to film you.
Yes, you do.
Okay. So I wanted to ask you a question. Why did you become a teacher?
Well, you know, it's early experience. My mom was a teacher. The other part of it is that I found myself in the Yukon in a small community that needed an instructor for a brand new satellite of the Yukon College. And I was able to secure that job, which sort of corresponded with my idea of community development. I also found teaching small children dance lessons was a lot of fun. So that's another reason why teaching appealed to me. And when I was a single parent, looking after three kids, teaching seemed to be a natural progression from my work as a behavior consultant, because I really liked working in schools and that provided an opportunity to develop a career that was sustaining. And overall, it's been a good experience.
So that was my mom. I'm doing this by my cell phone because I don't really have much other technology. So the picture is going to be a little bit odd. And I guess I should probably just talk about reason why she's my number one influence. One of the main reasons why she's my number one influence is because she never really gave up on me in the sense of this dream. Some of my other family members were pretty conservative in their viewpoint on becoming a teacher, considering where they know where what that means. But she always thought that I'd be a good teacher. She thought I'd be a good teacher from the get-go. And so that's one of the main reasons. And she just taught me a lot. She taught me how to get things organized. She's always been pretty upfront about what I needed to do, always pretty upfront about what I needed to work on in terms of getting there, and it's just nice to see that. And she worked really, really hard in order to get her teaching degree when she was in her 40s. So she's kind of laughing at me a little bit because, not really, laughing me a little bit because I'm so stressed about doing it in my early 30s, saying that I got lots of time in order to get the basics done and to become a good educator and a good role model for youth. Yeah. Gravity is working. And I guess, like, to get a little bit deeper, I think the reason why she's my number one inspiration, other than the fact that she did it, is just that she's a damn good teacher, if you'll pardon my language there. She's very well respected by the community, and she's well respected by her colleagues, and she's well liked by her students. And she's gotten to the point in which she functionally teaches teachers how to teach for particularly in special education for SP70. And I think if I was to be more like her, I'd be a better teacher if I had that. First of all, that level of knowledge, and secondly, that just ability to do the job well and do it with compassion and do it with professionalism. Wants to bring me down. Oh, twice as much ain't twice as good and can't sustain. Like one half could, it's wanting more. It's gonna send me to my knees.